Good morning and welcome. I'm Janet Asis. Now, myself and the crew have been here bringing you the latest election results, the election coverage from the Karas Regional Council, and it's definitely been a pleasure. Here's a recap on just some of the discussions that happened during the course of the week. Let's take a look. Good morning and welcome to this special production coming to you live from the Karas Regional Council as we give you the latest election coverage. A very good evening, Ellen.
Good evening, Janet.
Thank you so much for joining us, Ellen.
So that we know that young people can be exposed to these things where they don't have to sit at home.
I haven't seen any journalist having been or their lives threatened.
The youth must be given equal opportunities.
Covering the Nami News constituency with over 8,000 registered voters.
Everyone has a freedom of speech in terms of our constitution.
But now particularly this regional council and local authority elections, we are not going to use EVMs.
Before we get into the discussion, NBC reporter Salma Henock has scooped a joint award from the Merck Foundation, which recognizes the media in educating and sensitizing the public on COVID-19.
Maintenance of this environment, you know, is of utmost importance because that allows us as journalists give accurate information.
The process this year actually went a bit faster, although the sun is very hot in Kathmandu, but we were advised to bring on some chairs, put on a hat and extra water. So I think that also helped a lot of people.
There's issues with what's happening around within the job, that the pressure they cannot handle.
Shout out to Bruno King and Katsao.
All of us here in the studio, it's bye-bye Namibia. We'll see you later on. Well, that's just really some of the highlights there during the course of the week. And the highlights really for me was the discussion on the youth activists really sharing what changes they would like to see from the elected leadership. One young individual in particular really spoke about how these elections are not a popularity contest, but really talking about how they would want voters to vote for competent and credible leaders that have the capacity to ensure effective service deliveries for the communities that they serve. I really enjoyed my conversations with Chief Reporter Ellen Nanuses-Alberts, who shared with us that we reflected the election coverage over the years and how communities are really taking these elections seriously and holding these electorates accountable for ensuring service delivery. Also had discussions with the various journalists such as Daniel Nadunya as well as Natangwa Jimmy, just giving us an overview on the Ludgerts constituency areas as well as the Karasburg areas. Now, while we know that the LPM was successful in the Hardap region, it was a privilege for us as the news crew to witness the communities here in Ketmanswip celebrating the victory of the LPM and the newly elected councillors. We also had, later in the week, we had a discussion on the role of the media in elections, and the key really for me was just that ensuring that the media maintains objectivity in their reporting, being the voice of the community and being fair and providing accurate and timely information to the public. Now, a special production like this takes on plenty investments from the makeup, the equipment that we use here to ensure this whole production happens, the technical crew that really makes sure this production happens. And they've been working around the clock to ensure that we get the latest election coverage from the Karas region. And this is just what some of the team have to say.
It was a long but productive week. Thank you very much, Kim Pitmanswap. Job well done.
It was a long week, but well worth it. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.
It was not an easy production, but we pulled it off. And as always, NBC delivers. It was an honor to be a part of this team, and I hope you guys enjoyed it.
As always, we strive for the best.
Welcome to the newly elected leadership in the
to really hold the public accountable to ensure effective service delivery. Ultimately, we all want development for this beautiful country we call Namibia. We'd also like to thank the guests that joined us as being part of the discussion, the ECN, for also availing themselves, and also the various sponsors, Stadafids Namibia and Fernmart Ketmanshoop, as well as Tamara, our makeup artist from Radiance Health and Skincare, for really contributing to the success of this production. It has truly been a pleasure. From myself, Janet Asis, and the rest of the crew here in Ketmanshoop, it's definitely been a pleasure. Bye-bye, Namibia, and thank you.